Welcome to the session. Subject name is Mechanical Workshop Technology for third semester automobile students. Unit number is 2, Basic Fabrication Process. Under this chapter, we are going to discuss about submerged arc welding. Table of content, submerged arc welding. Process of submerged arc welding, features of submerged arc welding, its advantages, limitations, and its applications. Submerged arc welding. Submerged arc welding, or SAW, is one of the most occurring arc welding process. It needs a consumable electrode. It should be fed continuously by wire reel and a flux feed hopper to supply granular flux on the weld seam. In submerged welding, the arc is produced between a bare metal electrode and the workpiece. The submerged arc welding is mostly done on low carbon and alloy steels, but it may be used on many of the non-ferrous metals. Here, in submerged arc welding, the arc is invisible because it is hiding. It is covered by the flux layer, hence the name submerged arc welding. Submerged arc welding is a method in which the heat required to fuse the metal is generated by an arc formed by an electric current passing between the electrode and the workpiece. Here, power supply can be AC or DC, and the gap in between the electrode and the workpiece there generates arc. There is no visible arc and no sparks, spatter or fume. As I said, the arc is invisible. Hence the name submerged arc welding. The electrode may be a solid or cored wire or a strip. Submerged arc welding is normally a mechanized process. Figure shows the submerged arc welding setup. Process of submerged arc welding. In this welding process, a consumable bare electrode is used in combination with a flux feeder tube. The arc, end of the bare electrode, and molten pool remain completely submerged under blanket of granular flux. The molten weld and the arc zone are protected from atmospheric contamination by being submerged under a blanket of granular fusible flux consisting of lime, silica, manganese oxide, calcium fluoride, and other compounds. When molten, the flux becomes conductive and provides a current path between the electrode and the work. This thick layer of flux completely covers the molten metal, thus preventing spatter and sparks, as well as suppressing the intense ultraviolet radiations and fumes that are a part of the shielded metal arc welding process. As I said, here the arc is completely covered by the flux layer. So hence, the arc is invisible in the case of submerged arc welding. The feed of electrode and tube is automatic and the welding is homogeneous in structure. That is, the quality produced by the welding process is good. No pressure is applied for welding purposes. The process is normally limited to the flat and horizontal fillet welding positions. Observe the figure which is shown here for submerged arc welding. Here, consumable electrode, you can see blanket of granular flux, vacuum system for recovery of granular flux, slag, solidified weld metal, molten weld metal, molten flux, base metal. Travel direction is also shown in the figure. Granular flux from hopper. The blanket of granular flux submerges the welding operation, prevents sparks, spatter, and radiation. Coming to the features of submerged arc welding. First one, flux hopper. Flux hopper stores the flux and controls the rate of flux deposition on the welding joint. The flux is continuously supplied by a hopper in submerged arc welding process. Second one, welding head. It feeds flux and filler metal to the welding joint. Electrode, which is also known as a filler metal, gets energized here. Third one, flux. The granulated flux shields and thus protects molten weld from atmospheric contamination. The flux cleans weld metal and can modify its chemical composition also. Coming to the electrode, submerged arc welding filler material usually is a standard wire as well as other special forms. This wire normally has a thickness of 1.6 mm to 6 mm. That is, the thickness of the electrode will be 1.6 mm to 6 mm. Electrodes are available to weld mild steels, high carbon steels, low and special alloy steels, stainless steel, and some of the non-ferrous of copper and nickel. The electrode composition depends upon the material being welded. Means the electrode selected for the welding process definitely will be based on the type of the material being welded. Alloying elements may be added in the electrodes. Observe the figure which shows electrode wire, AC or DC current supply, lead. The current can be alternating current or DC current, direct current. Flux feed from hopper, flux feed to joint, welding head jaws, residual flux layer, slag layer, weld deposit, earth lead connection, direction of welding, flux layer. Coming to the advantages of submerged arc welding, first one is high quality. The welding joint which is produced by submerged arc welding is definitely high in quality and low distortion. Next one, little risk of undercut and porosity. No spatter. Here, 50 to 90% of the flux is recoverable, recycled and reused. Very little risk of lack of fusion due to deep and safe penetration. High deposition rate. Because of high deposition rate, the work is completed at a faster rate, which means the productivity of the submerged arc welding is high. Hence, you can finish the work by taking less amount of time in case of submerged arc welding, because it is due to high deposition rate of the material. High thermal efficiency, no radiation, welds produced are sound, uniform, ductile, corrosion resistant, and have good impact value. High welding speeds are possible. Because of the high welding speeds, you can complete the work by taking a less amount of time in case of submerged arc welding. The process is suitable for both indoor and outdoor works. Deep penetration rate, low distortion. And one more very important point of submerged arc welding is that 50 to 90% of the flux is recoverable, recycled and reused. The unused flux, it is again recycled and used further. Coming to the limitations of submerged arc welding. Precise joint preparation is required. In submerged arc welding, you have to prepare the joint previously before doing welding. So hence it comes under disadvantages or limitations. No observation of arc and process during welding is possible. As it is said earlier, here the arc is invisible because of the flux is covering the arc. Hence it is invisible in the case of submerged arc welding. Next limitation is a high operational effort. It cannot be used for plates less than 5 mm thickness, because 5 mm and less than 5 mm thickness plates cannot be welded by using submerged arc welding process. And next one is flux is subjected to contamination and adsorption of moisture, solidification, cracking, irregular wire feed. Sometimes it is possible the wire feed may discontinue. So hence it is one of the limitation of submerged arc welding. Coming to the applications of submerged arc welding. Fabrication of a boiler pressure vessel, railroad tank cars, structural shapes, circular welds, beam production. Next, shipbuilding, circumference welding, in wind tower fabrication. In order to install a wind tower, sometimes it needs a submerged arc welding. So in wind towers, submerged arc welding is done wherever it is required. Next, longitudinal pipe welding. Nickel base alloys, surface applications. Frequently asked questions or FAQs. What is submerged arc welding? Explain about the process of submerged arc welding. Describe the features of the submerged arc welding. Next one, what are the advantages, limitations and applications of submerged arc welding? So in this topic, the frequently asked questions are, what is submerged arc welding? With the information given till now, you have to be in a position to write about what is the meaning of submerged arc welding. Next one is explain about the process of submerged arc welding, how the process is carried out, how the arc is produced between the electrode and the workpiece, and why it is named as submerged arc welding, and which is covering the arc. So it is already explained. Third one is describe the features of the submerged arc welding. What are the features which are deciding that the submerged arc welding is this? And what are the advantages, limitations and applications of submerged arc welding? Coming to multiple choice questions. So multiple choice questions are nothing but for every question we will be having four answers. Under the four answers we have to select the right answer. Here the first multiple choice question is the electrode which is used in submerged arc welding is in which form, whether it is in solid form, cold wire, strip, or all of the above. So till now we have discussed about a submerged arc welding, what are its features, what are the advantages, what are the applications, how the process is carried out. So the based on that information you will be in a position to decide correctly the answer. So the electrode which is used in submerged arc welding is in solid form, cold wired form, strip form. So hence the answer is all of the above. Second multiple choice question is in which position is submerged arc welding is done. So we have already discussed the answer is flat and horizontal. So most of the times submerged arc welding is used for welding the objects which are placed flat and horizontal in surface. So the answer is the correct answer is flat and horizontal position. Third multiple choice question is 50 to 90% of the flux is recoverable, recycled and reused. Is this statement true or false? The answer is true. We discussed earlier that 50 to 90% of the flux which is used in submerged arc welding is recoverable, recycled and reused. Hence the statement is true. Therefore the answer is A. Fourth question is submerged arc welding is a process that generally gives low penetration, slag free welds, high heat input, low dilution. The correct answer is high heat input. Next multiple choice question is what is the function of a flux in submerged arc welding? Whether it is to completely cover the welded zone, to prevent oxidation of joint, to prevent spattering of molten metal, to prevent sticking of molten metal. The right answer is it is D, to prevent sticking of molten metal. So because as we discussed till now, what is the function of flux in submerged arc welding is it is to prevent sticking of molten metal. Thank you.